गुड इवनिंग
गुड इवनिंग सर।
केमिकल काइनेटिक्स Is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Chemical kinetics. Here it is actually thermodynamics computer board part.
Yes, sir.
Thermodynamics. Here it is delta G equal to delta H minus
T into delta S.
T delta S. If delta G equal to values possible negative, delta G equal to values possible positive, and delta G equal to zero.
Zero.
Delta G equal to negative reaction is
spontaneous.
This is
non-spontaneous.
This is reaction at
equilibrium.
And like the same way, delta S equal to values also possible positive. Delta S equal to negative, delta S equal to zero. What about this delta S equal to positive reaction is?
Spontaneous.
Delta S equal to negative reaction is non-spontaneous. Again, this is at the reaction is at the?
Equilibrium.
So here it is, according to thermodynamics, we can give answer either the reaction is spontaneous or non-spontaneous. But if reaction is spontaneous, with what speed reaction is possible? That we discuss under
chemical kinetics.
According to thermodynamics, a chemical reaction between two reactants, the reaction is possible or not, is it give product or not, that we get the idea. But if product possible, with what speed the reaction will complete? That is chemical kinetics. Kinetics means speed. We are totally chemical kinetics explain about the speed of the reaction. Write down. Chemical kinetics explains speed of the reaction. Chemical kinetics explains about speed of the reaction. Speed in brackets, write down rate of the reaction. Rate of the reaction, simply into your question paper, they will give like this. ROR, rate of reaction. Chemical kinetics explains about rate of the reaction. Listen here, according to kinetics, reactions totally three types. The three type reactions, fast reactions, moderate reactions, slow reactions. Fast reactions means reactions which complete in a fraction of seconds. Those we called fast reactions. Reactions which required hours, days, years like that time, that we called
slow reactions.
For suppose reason, I am taking HCl. For this, I am adding NaOH. The product is NaCl plus
H2O.
This is a acid-base reaction, precipitation reaction. This is very
fast
reaction. We can't guess the time. There is no technical method to measure the time for these fast reactions. And these are the slow reactions. Then slow reactions means rusting of iron. So this is a slow type reaction. So here it is, very slow reactions we can give directly how much time. For suppose rusting of iron required some days to hours like that, days, years like that time, here it is slow reaction we can give. Moderate reaction is there, na? These two reactions also kinetics could not explain. Kinetics not explains about fast reactions. Kinetics not explains about
slow reactions.
Slow reaction. It explains about
moderate reaction.
Moderate reaction. Why it not explains speed of fast reactions means that is not possible. Very fraction of seconds enough to complete this type of reactions. These are slow reactions, very slow reactions. To check the speed, we also conduct the experiment very long time. That much long time maintaining experiment also not possible. So that's why slow reaction speed also we can't explain here. We can't explain fast reaction speed also. Here it is, kinetics explains about
moderate
reactions. These are very fast reactions. That's why we can't explain the speed. These are very slow reactions. That much time the experiment is not possible. That's why these also we can't explain. So now these moderate reactions. Now here it is. First of all, what is the speed of reaction? I'm taking here it is. Reactants gives rise to products. By passing the time, this reactant's concentration
increases.
Product concentration
increases.
So decrease in the concentration of reactants or increase in the concentration of products with respect to
time.
That we called
rate of reaction.
Rate of reaction. Decrease in the concentration of reactant or increase in the concentration of product with respect to time we call the rate of
reaction.
Or suppose all gaseous reactions they given means at that time instead of concentration we take. If liquids they given means we can take concentration, but the gas reactants they given. So concentration is possible for gases?
No, sir.
At that time we take pressure. Decrease in the reactant's pressure or increase in the concentration, increase in the pressure of
products
with respect to
time.
That we call rate of reaction. So now listen, here it is what I am taking. Here on reaction, reactants give rise to products. I'm taking time t equal to 0. Beginning, my reactants present A naught. What about products?
Zero.
So this is zero. After t seconds, some x reactants converted to products. How many moles of product will form?
A naught minus x.
No, better. X reactants converted to products means how much products formed within this t seconds?
X, sir.
X. How many reactants left here?
A naught minus x.
For suppose, listen, I'm giving to you like this reaction. 2A gives rise to some 3B I given. When t equal to 0, your reactants we are taken A naught. Listen, this we are taken, but reaction reacting 2 moles of A forming.
3 moles of
moles of B.
3 moles of this A naught, this is we are taking better. That is we are taking. But reaction is going itself 2A gives rise to
3B.
We are taking some quantity of A atoms, 2 moles of A reacting and forming 3 moles of B. So when t equal to 0, here how much? Products, 0. After t seconds, here how much concentration decreases?
2x.
Why? Because 2 moles of A reacting and forming 3 moles of?
3 moles of B.
B. So after t seconds, 2x moles of A disappeared. Means how many moles of A appeared? How many moles of A appear, brother? This
3x.
2A gives rise to 3B reaction. So beginning t equal to 0, this is A naught, this is 0. After t seconds, 2x moles of A disappeared. So according to the reaction, how many moles of B formed?
3x moles.
3x. So now how much reactants left here?
A naught minus 2x.
Minus 2x. Here how many moles of B formed? Means 3x.
3x.
So means this A naught we will take. Reaction goes according to the chemical equation. Products also formed according to the chemical
equation.
Equation. For suppose I am just changing the reaction. Here it is. This is A plus B gives rise to some C I given. A plus B gives rise to C. Now time t equal to 0. X moles of this and Y moles of this disappeared. So now how many moles formed?
0 moles.
0 moles.
0 moles. So after t seconds. Sorry, better. This you take A naught. This you take B naught. That is 0. Here, how many moles disappeared?
1.
X. X.
Here, how many moles better? X are 2X or 3X?
X.
X.
X. Here, how much disappeared?
X.
Why?
X. Here, how much formed?
X.
X. After 3 X. seconds, how much A left?
A naught minus X.
Now, how you are getting the language of kinetics or not?
Yes, sir.
So, listen, this A naught, B naught we are taking to start the reaction. But reaction, how it is going, that is the reaction step, that is. So, here what is the stoichiometry present? Like that you disappear and the remaining will form like this. So, now here it is, listen. This reactants gives rise to products when t equal to 0. This is A naught, this is 0. After some time, X moles of reactants are disappeared, X moles of products are formed. After this t seconds, A naught minus X reactants remaining. X reactants are formed. Now listen, rate of reaction with respect to 2. With respect to A equal to, what is the rate of reaction? Decrease in the concentration of reactants with respect to
time.
What about products? Increase in the concentration with respect to
time.
So now listen, here it is. How I calculate the concentration, rate of reaction with respect to A? Here one thing I am explaining, rate of reaction is nothing but change in concentration with respect to
time.
Change means that is with respect to reactants decrease, with respect to product it is
increase.
Change, how we calculate final minus
initial.
So reactant concentration change I am calculating. Final how much?
A naught minus X.
A naught minus X. What about initial?
A naught.
Minus A naught. My final time T. Initial time 0.
0.
So totally here it is T. This A naught cancel out. So rate of reaction with respect to A minus X by
T.
T. But listen, rate of reaction never be
negative.
Negative.
Always positive. Rate is nothing but speed only. Na. Speed never be
negative.
Speed minimum value is 0. But zero. It never be
negative.
But here I am getting negative. Just wait. The same reactants gives rise to products I am taking. Time t equal to 0. This is A naught. This is 0. After t seconds, X moles of reactants disappear to form X moles of products. So now reactants left is A naught minus X, product formula also X. So now I am calculating rate of reaction with respect to product P. So change in concentration by change in
time.
Time. What about change in concentration? Final minus?
Initial.
Initial.
X minus.
So x minus
zero.
Minus zero.
Zero
by t minus
t zero.
Equal. I am getting
x by t.
X by t.
Here it is. Sir, can I write it is plus x by t?
Yes, sir.
Can I write this is a minus of minus? This is also plus x by t. Or else I am writing here this minus as it is. I am taking here minus x by t. Here it is what plus x by t. This negative charge is representing decrease in concentration of
reactants.
Reactants. This plus sign represents here it is
increasing concentration of
concentration of products. So here it is. Listen carefully. Wherever you are calculating rate of reaction with respect to reactants. Compulsory, we have to write outside minus. That minus and this minus both become
plus.
Plus. Or else this negative charge represents you just take as it is decreasing concentration of
reactants.
Why? Because concentration never be speed never be
negative.
Negative speed should be positive. So to remove that mathematical error, we have to take here
minus.
When we are calculating rate of reaction with respect to
reactants.
It is rate of reaction with respect to A. It is rate of reaction with respect to B.
B.
Shall I give you some questions?
Yes, sir.
Write down data. A plus 3B gives rise to 4C. 2A plus 3B gives rise to 4C. Calculate rate of reaction. Calculate rate of reaction with respect to A, with respect to B, and with respect to C. Calculate rate of reaction with respect to A, with respect to B, with respect to C. First question I am doing. Second, third questions I will allot for you. Chalo beta, see this side. Beginning time t equal to 0. This concentration we take.
A naught.
A naught. This concentration is?
B
naught.
What about this concentration?
0.
0.
After t seconds.
X
naught.
T seconds.
This is what?
X. 2x.
2x. 2x.
This is
3x.
3x. Here it is
4x.
So now how much A remains?
A0
minus 2x.
This is what? B0 minus
3x. B0 minus 3x.
This is
4x.
4x.
Now rate of reaction. Rate of reaction with respect to A. Change in concentration with respect to A by changing
time.
But we have to take for reactants outside compulsory
minus.
Or else if minus remains, that you have to assume decreasing
concentration of
reactants. But suppose, listen carefully. Here only I will give one question. So here it is written, what is final concentration? A naught minus
2x minus A naught.
Minus
2x minus A naught by
T. This A naught, this A naught cancel.
2x by T.
2x by T. It is rate of reaction with respect to
A.
A. What is this x beta? Decreasing. Decrease in concentration of A, decrease in concentration of B, or formation of concentration of C. That meaning within this T seconds, 2x moles of A disappeared, 3x moles of
B disappeared.
B
He disappeared.
He disappeared and 4x moles of C.
Formed.
So now here I am writing rate of reaction with respect to 2. With respect to B equal.
3x by T.
Dx by T.
Can I write directly?
Yes, sir.
Dx by T. So now I am writing rate of reaction with respect to 2, C.
4x
rate of reaction with respect to C.
4x by T.
4x by T.
4x by T. So now here it is. Here, listen carefully. Rate of reaction with respect to A. Rate of reaction with respect to A. What is rate of reaction with respect to A? Change in
concentration of A by change in time.
By change in time. Change, can I write a difference? Difference in the concentration of A by difference in
time.
Time. So can I write like this? D of A by
dt.
Dt.
Dt. Am I correct or not?
Yes, sir.
So can I write it is minus D of A by dt? Why yes, minus D of A by dt? This is
reactant.
Reactant concentration. With respect to reactant, if you want rate of reaction, compulsory you start your equation with
minus.
Negative.
Otherwise, your answer will come in
negative.
Speed never be negative. That's why beginning only we are using one.
Minus.
So this is equal to what is the answer here? It is 2x by.
2x by t.
2x by t.
2x by t. So now here it is rate of reaction with respect to B equal to minus of dd by
dt
is equal to almost
3x by t.
So now rate of reaction with respect to C. This is minus dc by dt or plus dc by dt?
Plus dc by dc by dt.
Plus dc by dt is equal to what? That is 4x
by dt.
4x by t. Now listen, this 2x by t equal to that x by t equal to I am writing. What about x by t equal to?
1 by 2 into my
1 by 2 into minus of
dA by dt.
Here also I am writing x by t equal to
1 by 3 into minus of dB by dt.
Minus of dB by dt. This is equal. Here also x by t equal to
1 by 4 into dc by dt.
1 by 4 into dc by
dt.
So listen, x by t equal to 1 by 2 minus d of a by dt. This equal to 1 by 3 into minus d of b by dt. This equal to 1 by 4 into d of c by dt. What is this x by t?
Speed.
What is this x by t? This is. Listen here. What is minus d of a by dt?
Rate of reaction
with respect to
A.
This is the rate of reaction with respect to
B.
It is rate of reaction with respect to
C.
This x by t is there, that is overall rate of reaction. Overall rate of reaction meaning this x by t meaning is within this t seconds. 2x moles of A disappeared, 3x moles of B disappeared, and 4x moles of
C formed.
That we call as x by t. This we call just rate of reaction. Overall rate of reaction, but these three are rate of reaction with respect to A, rate of reaction with respect to
B,
B
and rate of reaction with respect to C.
Given
here two type of questions they will form. Here it is. First, here it is rate of reaction with respect to A. Simply, here it is minus B of A by
dt.
dt. They will give final concentration, they will give initial concentration, they will give time. So final concentration minus
initial concentration by change in
time. Initial concentration divided by final time minus
initial time.
But listen here, it is, this is same d of a by dt we are taking. This is, we are taking this side what, 1 by 2. What is this 2, 3, 4?
Number of moles.
These are stoichiometric
coefficients.
If you want to calculate overall rate of reaction, this is rate of reaction with respect to a particular reactant. This is particular reactant, it is particular
product.
Those we have to divide with there.
Stoichiometric coefficient.
Can I write like this? Rate of reaction is equal to 1 by stoichiometric coefficient into 1 by stoichiometric coefficient into rate of reaction with respect to product or reactant. Can I write correct or not?
Yes, sir.
This is minus d of A by dt, minus d of A by dB by dt, dc by dt. This is rate of reaction with respect to A. This is rate of reaction with respect to A. This is rate of reaction with respect to C. That will be divided with the stoichiometric
coefficient.
That meaning, listen carefully, rate of reaction with respect to particular reactant or particular product, you don't want any stoichiometric
coefficient.
But overall rate of reaction, if you want compressor, you have to take
stoichiometric coefficient.
Stoichiometric coefficient. For suppose I am asking one question. Minus dA by dt represents what?
Rate of reaction with respect to A.
1 by 2 minus dA by dt represents what?
Overall rate of reaction.
With respect to A, speed is different. With respect to B, speed is different. With respect to C, speed is different. But listen carefully. Out of these three, which reaction is slow? That is only your reaction final speed. That only we called RDS. Rate determining. Rate determining step. So listen here, it is. So here, if you want overall rate of reaction, your overall rate of reaction is there, now. That overall rate of reaction, you has to use compulsory stoichiometric.
Stoichiometric coefficients.
Write down there. Complete this first. If completed, you ask, I will give the note point for you. All are downloaded kinetics notes from WhatsApp?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Okay. Rough notes you write down better. In that clearly I given with a number of questions, you follow that notes. Are clear or not? Here it is. With respect to particular reactant, particular product, we don't want any stoichiometric
coefficient.
But overall rate of reaction, if you want compulsory, we have to take
stoichiometric coefficient.
Shall I give the note point?
Yes, sir.
Rate of reaction with respect to particular reactant or product. Don't want stoichiometric coefficients, or else no need stoichiometric coefficients. But to measure overall rate of reaction, but to measure overall rate of reaction. Stoichiometric coefficients are compulsory. Stoichiometric coefficients are compulsory. Write down question. XA plus YB gives rise to XA plus YB gives rise to ZC. XA plus YB gives rise to ZC. Calculate rate of reaction with respect to reactants and products. Rate of reaction with respect to reactants and products, and also calculate overall rate of reaction. And also calculate overall rate of reaction with units. With units. XA plus YB gives rise to ZC. Okay. So here it is T equal to 0. This is
A naught.
Directly you write down minus D of A by DT is equal to its rate of reaction with respect to
A.
So can I take stoichiometric coefficients or not?
No, sir.
We don't need to take stoichiometric. Unless you give like this. Overall rate of reaction equal to 10. Overall rate of reaction equal to
1 by stoichi.
1 by X of minus D of A.
DT
is equal to
1 by y minus d of b by dt equal to 1 by z d of
c by dt
So what about this minus d of a by dt minus d of b by dt minus d of c by dt? These are rate of reactions with respect to a, b and l
and c.
But 1 by x into minus d of a by dt overall.
Overall rate of reaction.
Overall rate of reaction. Okay. What are the units for rate of reaction? This is concentration. This is?
Time.
So concentration per?
Second.
So concentration units are mole per? Liter,
second inverse.
Mole per liter per second inverse. But listen carefully. Here they given second inverse means they are very fast reactions. Minutes to hours they given means that is moderate reactions. Or as days, years like that they given means that is very
very slow reaction.
Very slow reaction. And listen, this is one more. What about PV equal to?
NRT.
So P equal to N by V into?
RT.
What is N by V?
Concentration.
Concentration. P equal to C into?
RT.
Here we know answer in concentration terms, but I want to answer in pressure terms. This concentration answer only I have to multiply with universal gas constant and
temperature.
If you know concentration answer, if you want to convert that into pressure terms, this concentration answer you have to multiply with universal gas constant and
temperature.
For suppose in concentration terms only you know the answer. C equal to P by RT. So means you have to divide with universal gas constant and
temperature.
So that one unit to another unit we can change the answers. Here if you want pressure terms, the units are atmosphere per. Instead of concentration, pressure will come. Na?
Yes, sir.
So your units are atmosphere per time.
Per second.
Atmosphere per second.
Mm.
Atmosphere per second. In concentration terms, mole per liter per second. In pressure terms, that is atm per second. Atm per second. This is mole per liter per second. This is atm per second. But we can change concentration answers to pressure answers. Pressure answers to
concentration.
Concentration answers. That root is P equal to C into
RT.
Write down one more question. Write expression for rate of reaction. Write expression for rate of reaction for the following. Write expression for rate of reaction for the following. First one. 2H2O2 gives rise to 2H2O plus O2 What is first one? Rate of reaction equal to
one by two into concentration of H2O2.
1/2 into
minus
D of H2O2
by
D.
This is equal to
1/2 into d of h2o by dt
minus or plus?
Plus.
This is equal to plus
d of h2o by dt.
What about here? Rate of reaction is equal to
minus d of n2 by dt.
It is equal to
minus 1/3 into d of h2 by dt.
Dt,
it is equal to
1/2
into
d of nh3 by dt
plus d of nh3 by
dt.
Listen, this second question is there. This is what about third one? Rate of reaction is equal to 1/2 minus d of h2 by dt. Equal to
in minus
d of h2 by dt.
Equal to
1/2 into d of h2o3 by dt.
D of h2o3 by
dt.
What about fourth answer?
Rate of reaction equal to minus
two. Rate of reaction equal to
minus 2 into dA by dt.
Minus 2 into dA by dt equal to?
Minus 3 into dB by dt.
Equal to?
3.
5 into plus dc by
dc by dt.
dc by dt. 2 into minus of dA by dt equal to 3 into minus of dB by dt equal to 3 into plus
dc by dt.
Right, the next question. 2a plus 3b gives rise to 5c. 2a plus 3b gives rise to 5c. Initial concentration of A is 10 moles. Initial concentration of A is 10 moles, which changes to 5 moles. Which changes to 5 moles in 20 seconds. In 20 seconds, I'm repeating once again. 2a plus 3b gives rise to 5c. Initial concentration of A is 10 moles, which changes to 5 moles in 20 seconds. Then calculate question number 1. Rate of reaction of A. Question number 2. Rate of reaction. Question number 3. Value of minus dB by dt, comma plus dc by dt. Value of minus dB by dt, comma plus dc by dt. Shall I repeat once again the question?
Yes, sir.
2a plus 3b gives rise to 5c. Initial concentration of A is 10 moles, which changes to 5 moles in 20 seconds. Then calculate. Question number 1. Rate of reaction with respect to A. Question number 2, rate of reaction. Question number 3, value of minus dB by dt plus dc by dt. What is the equation?
2a plus 3b
equal to
5c. 2a
plus
3b
is equal to
5c.
So now rate of reaction is equal to 1 by 2 minus d of a by
dt.
This is equal to 1 by 3 minus d of a by dt. This is equal to 1 by 5.
5 into plus of
dc by dt.
Plus the dc by dt. Now what is the clues they given in the question?
Initial concentration of A and final concentration of A.
Initial concentration of
A.
How much?
10 moles.
10 moles.
So now here it is, when t equal to 0, this is 10 moles they given. Okay? Which changes to?
5 moles.
In 20 seconds.
So 10 moles changes to? How many moles?
5 moles.
For that, how much time taken?
T equal to 20 seconds.
20 seconds. So now here it is. First, I am calculating minus d of a by dt. What is minus d of a dt? Final concentration minus?
Initial concentration by?
Divided by final time minus?
Initial time.
Initial time.
What about final concentration?
5 minus 10 by
concentration 0 divided by
10.
This is how much? Final concentration is, initial concentration is
10.
So totally, what is your answer here? Is
5 by 5 by 20, 1 by 4.
This is 0.25. So this is minus d of E by dt. So it is a rate of reaction with respect to
A.
For suppose if I want rate of reaction with respect to B. Rate of reaction with respect to A, I calculated 0.25 or 1 by 4. I want rate of reaction with respect to B.
Overall so rate of reaction.
3 into. Listen, one thing I'm telling, this is minus D of A by dt only.
Yes, sir.
Now I'm calculating rate of reaction is equal to 1 by 2 into minus D of A by
dt.
What about minus D of A by dt?
0.25.
1 by 8.
What about minus D of B by dt?
3 by 8.
3 into R or only?
Yes, yes.
3 by
8.
What about minus, plus DC by dt?
5 by 8.
This is 5 into
rate of reaction.
That is 5 by 8. In our question also, they are asking overall rate of reaction. Rate of reaction with respect to A, with respect to B, with respect to
C.
One question for homework. Completed?
Yes, sir.
Write down. For the formation of ammonia, from N2 and H2, rate of consumption of N2 is, what is the meaning of consumption? Disappearance. Rate of consumption of N2 is 1.5 into 10 power minus 3 mole per second. 1.5 into 10 power minus 3 mole per second. Calculate rate of reaction with respect to N2. Calculate rate of reaction with respect to N2, with respect to H2. Calculate rate of reaction with respect to N2, with respect to H2, with respect to ammonia,